What do you do, entertainment junkies? It's your boy Infa.
And it's your girl Nantla Moons.
And today we're talking 1802. Let's get into it. So we watched 1802.
Mm-hmm.
We love Defies Time. What are your thoughts about it? Let's start with your thoughts. Yeah.
Yo, there's so many thoughts running around the Love Defies Time because they have a great cast.
The cast is amazing.
And the fact that it's an all black cast, I'm proud of it. I'm happy.
Yeah.
About that, but I'm not really happy.
Okay.
Wow. I'm not really happy. Honestly speaking, look at the switch. I mean, the storyline from the beginning, we kind of get it.
Mm-hmm.
Ne? The switch from
the past into the future.
The past into the future, yeah. And how they just, you know.
In fact, the same thing was brought up about the show Lioness.
Uh-huh.
It also had like a bunch of jumps in time. They would go into the past and then they would go into the future.
Mm-hmm.
And then they would go to a time in between and then they would jump. And people were just like, bruh, I'm confused. Where are we in the story?
Mm-hmm.
Like, how? It was quite tough for a lot of people to follow. And I think in this story, I mean, if they just visually did something, like
mm-hmm.
added a different filter just mm-hmm. to let people know that, hey, this is where we are right now.
Honestly, I feel like they exaggerated the whole thing. Truly speaking.
Really? Which part do you think they exaggerated?
Like, look at how the lady, how she goes to the cave. Do you think when I, a black person, would just go
part,
to a cave like that?
That part was ridiculous. I also was like, there's no way. If I saw if I was facing that cave, darkness, I don't see what's going on. I'm leaving, same time.
You
I'm
run
running
for your life.
There's no, I don't have time for these things.
So
I mean, there was a reason why that amulet was not found in 2,000 years. It's because
mm-hmm.
no one is going to walk into a cave and just be like, oh, what's going on?
And then they just decided that lady must just walk into the cave and be the one that finds it. And how she's so calm.
About the whole thing. When she comes out, she looks like there's nothing. In every direction, you are literally in the middle of nowhere. And you're just like, signal. Yo, bruh. Follow-up question. If you were thrown 200 years into the past,
uh-huh.
how long do you think you'd survive?
Yo.
Do you think you would cope?
Hey,
Because on the show, they already uh-huh. treat her like she's some sort of creature.
Mm.
She's not dressed like normal
people.
She's got a weave on. They're just like, what's going on? Makeup, all of this. They're confused by her. Black people were not, you know, suspicious and superstitious.
Back in the days.
We wouldn't have taken it like that. Like the reaction of the people around the prince, I
mm-hmm.
feel like it's more authentic. That is how we, as black people, we would
Thank
be
you.
Very suspicious.
Thank you.
Would
but look at
suspicious.
How come the prince and the king, they're so
they're
calm.
They're just like,
you know,
time traveling.
Leave her alone.
Yeah.
I feel like this show was kind of rushed
mm-hmm.
a bit. Like, even looking at the camera angles,
yeah.
like where they're fighting, the two tribes, the two different tribes, I feel like they would have used angles
yeah.
that will, you know.
That is as good as our fight scenes are.
I'm not proud. Even where they stabbed the prince, the makeup, I mean.
Yeah, all of that was, it looked bad. It looked like they used cough syrup.
You know,
and then they were just like, go. You can tell what that is not a priority. I don't know why they even added the fight scenes. They can just say a battle happened, but I guess the brother had to be stabbed somehow.
Yes.
Because there's also a beef between
the
brothers as
their
well.
Their own family,
which is what I don't like about like the whole royal family situation. That's why I would never try to be part of royal. Because your family...
Because they're the people that actually look down on you and they don't want to see you on that throne.
No.
You know?
Your own brother will kill you, bruh.
Your own brother. Imagine. And it's from the other wife.
So do you think that's why he feels less attached to him and was willing to kill him is because they have different mothers?
I feel like it's more of greed. Because looking at back in the days, these people, they call it istembu, right?
Mm-hmm.
Polygamy.
So
back in the days, you know that if you have four wives, all the kids, they get along. You find that the first wife's kids, they also come and stay with the last wife. You understand? So
family was extremely important.
Family is
especially
in those kind of
relationships, tembu, you know, can be complicated.
Very complicated.
And we see that with the first two wives fighting, you know, and this guy's on his deathbed, but it's still alive, which blows my mind. But it's culture.
Right.
So actually, good question. How do you feel about that still?
I would never.
No, but like, I'm not going to say you should. Mm-hmm. Mara, your friend is saying, you know what, I'm going to be, I think I'm going to do this. I'm dating this guy, he's married. I'm thinking, you know what, he proposed to me to be his second wife. I'm thinking of going for it. What advice would you give him?
I'm not even gonna give you advice. I'll just be supportive.
Oh, okay.
That's the only thing. But otherwise,
because you know, at least in that situation, I don't know about the first wife. Mm-hmm. My other parties are for it. They're just like, I know
can do
what
it.
Exactly. Well, it's obvious reasons why the husband. But the second wife, obviously she loves the guy.
The first wife, Pella, you must know that she's been there through it all. Before all these other wives on the side, they came in.
She has it the roughest, I feel like. Even though technically she has the most authority as the first wife, Marie, I have it rough, sis.
I feel like they could have just put in a lot of work. Especially when it comes to research. I'm not saying that it wasn't well researched.
Mm-hmm.
It was researched, but how they tried to merge the past with the present day and the picture. The Nguni cultures together. The whole story is like Xhosa, right? But then when you look at the actors, some of the actors, their accent is, it goes south. You know,
and
instead
you know
of going north.
Ungabani.
But they should have taken that cast from 1809 to the present day, because you'd understand with the broken Xhosa.
Oh,
but then if they're that using that kind of Xhosa in 1809, it would be interesting, you know. And the king. I'm sorry, I have a problem with the king. I'm not proud.
I love the way he spoke.
No.
I died of laughter.
It's like he's trying to convince us, Oti, he's sick. You know the voice?
coughing every...
he's forcing it out to sound, you know?
Yeah, so 1802, our final reviews, our final thoughts. Having seen the first two episodes, would you continue watching it?
I would actually continue watching
as it. As a Xhosa lady.
I would continue watching it. Remember when you said... we want to see you don't think there's going to be other fight scenes. So I actually want to see how they improve the camera on the show, the camera angles, how they continue with the storyline and where I think I would watch it, but up to a certain point.
You think we're going to pull a Yizo Yizo? I recently watched Yizo Yizo.
Same here.
One.
The first is right.
And it's the shooting, the cameras, like the episodes, it's not the same. Between like one moment is here. So maybe that will happen.
And the quality.
So we'll just see as time goes. But I guess I would also continue watching it.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's a worthwhile show. I think, especially if you are Xhosa or you're interested in learning more about culture because it is set in the past, I think it would be an interesting watch. So I'll give it a thumbs up. I recommend it. I think you guys should check it out. You?
I'm also giving it a thumbs up.
Yeah. It's not perfect, but I think it's a good watch.
It is. Yeah. And because of the picture quality, I feel like they have the best equipment.
We're going to get there. So that's been us, guys. We'd like to hear what your guys' thoughts are on the show. What did you guys think of the first few episodes? Would you continue watching it? Yes or no? Leave your comments below. And if you like the show, please make sure that you follow us, subscribe, share, do all the good stuff. And yeah, we'll see you guys again soon.
Peace out.
Deuces.